praise your name. We praise, we praise your name. We praise your name. We praise your name.
We're standing. Can I call upon Mrs. Bess Gankolongo to come and open for us in prayer, and then we start the proceedings. Mfundisi, you can open for us in prayer. Amen. Thank you. May be seated. Umfundisi uthi moluti uyitse, the pastor said, ngegama lenkosi yethu elihle. I would like to draw your attention to Romans 14 verse 8. If we live for the Lord. If we die for the Lord. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Our child, our son, is with the Lord ngalomzuzu. Uthixo usemhle nangoku. Ubuhlungu, it's painful for all of us because we don't understand. You and I don't know the time and place, but we are here doing our best. One thing I can tell you about Arethabeng, he came here to bless us with laughter, with happiness. And when his assignment was done, the Lord called him to his eternal place. Ritlo Taba, we are here to celebrate Arethabeng, Anthony Jr. Lennon. Good morning, and thank you so much for gracing us with your comfort. Please remember that we are here to celebrate his life, to comfort the family. They must never walk away from this feeling the same way again. Everything that we're going to be sharing today must help them to acknowledge and understand that even in this grief, in this pain, God is still God. God is still God. We love them. We appreciate them. But they don't belong to us. They belong to their maker. I'd like to now call upon our auntie who's also a minister, Margaret Lennon, to come and speak on behalf of the family.
Baba kulungile makuyintando yakho okwenzeke empilweni zethu.
Kulungile.
Good morning. I bring greetings and from the Lennon family. Primarily we're in United States, Maryland, North Carolina, Colorado, California, Texas, North Carolina, as I said, I hope I said it anyway, Georgia. So I just, we have a large family. My parents had 12 children, 6 boys and 6 girls. Anthony, Tony is my nephew from my oldest brother. So he's very precious to us. So we want you to know that though they could not be here, Tony and Tabby and all the family and friends that they have here, we want to honor the pastor, of course, and it's been here since I've been here and just brought them such peace and such comfort. And I do want to thank you guys for doing what we would have done if they'd been in the United States. But being here, you have done probably as much as more than we would have done. So I want to say thank you. And I do have just one little word I want to say to you guys. I think from the Lord for all of us. And it's in Isaiah chapter 30. But it says, in quietness and in confidence shall be your strength. You know, in this life, it's a lot of noise going on everywhere you go. We have television, we have radio, we have the computer. We have a lot of things to keep our minds and our hearts off of what's really important. And I think God wants to remind us today that sometimes we need to get some quiet time to just ponder on Him, ponder on life, ponder on where God wants us to be in life. And with Ari here, ponder on what does all this mean? For us, there's a message in it for all of us. And so God is saying to us, in quietness and confidence, where's your confidence in Christ? Your confidence in Him. And guess what? He will give you strength to get through this and anything else life has to offer you if you just put your trust and confidence in Him. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Auntie Margaret. All of us are here for a certain reason, for a specific reason, and there's a reason for everything that's happening to us. As we know that life doesn't just happen to us, it happens through us and for us. Even this moment, as tragic as it feels, it is for us. As we ponder on what this moment means for us, all of us have been given a specific assignment. This one was giving Arethabeng, happiness. And if you knew Ari, you would know wherever he is, there was just happiness and joy. And once you're done with your assignment, some of us are here to shed light. Some of us are here to teach. Some of us are here to cause chaos. Once the chaos is caused, that's it. Your assignment is done. So he was here to give us joy. As we cry, just meditate on that. Remember his smile that was just there as a mark. Remember where in his presence there was always joy. And that is exactly why he was here. And remembering that he is with the Lord right now. I'd like to now call upon perhaps DJ or the next speaker. All to on behalf of the Pudumo family, I'd like to call upon Malumatsona, Mr. Thabo Pudumo. right. He seems not to be here yet. But as we sing, I'd like us to help stand Mr. Johnny and friends who are going to give us an item. If you can just kindly help them gather their throats and their thoughts, DJ.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
There's no way you can sing this song sitting down. We're here to celebrate Ari's life. One thing I know about Brad John, Joni, Lady Chomiza, they will not stop. So I'm going to humbly request that they just become part of the furniture when we ask for a hymn, but it's a hand. Radumelan. Yeah, because banaliona that thing, right? Yes, but fa-fa-fa-vum. We are here, Hutsidisa, Sizo Kalisa, Laikaya. Sisuli nyembezi and seal the wounds, and it can't be sealing the wounds. God, oh please, nah, not in this gathering. I'd like to now call upon Malumatsona. When we called him earlier on, he was looking for a wire. abatla ho etsa dintho tsa bo malome and make sure that the memory is just present. It's right there, and I'm told that you are going to, you're looking for a song. Is that you? No, ma'am. Pela wena ke a tse boro entertainment ka molomo fela. Maloma tsone.
Saying a few things about this beautiful, remarkable soul, Amen. Firstly, let me promise you, Hore, I won't cry today. I'm stronger because of this gentleman. Arethabeng, when he was born, I remember I was talking to a friend not long ago. The guy that I just met, which I always say to my family members and my friends, that everything happens for a reason, and I bet you the reason is never wrong. You'll later realize whatever that happened, this is the purpose of it. So Arethabeng leaving us so early doesn't mean that there was a mistake. No, we all know that the living God that we are serving makes no mistakes. And he's never early, he's never late, he's always on time. And I try to learn from what people always say when they talk about always on time. So what happened to this young man, obviously it surprises you, but moreover, it surprises mama gagwe le ntate wa gagwe, because every parent wants to be buried by their children. We are not supposed to be buried by our parents. When the parents die and a child is there, it's not too much. It is stress, but not too much stress like when a child dies and the parents has to bury the child. Who will be burying the parents if the child is gone? So, Arethabeng, you left us too soon, big boy. There's, like I said, there's 100 things to say, but I choose to tell you that you're being loved and you created so many families. We all are one thing because of this young boy. I remember yesterday as I was driving a crew of his friends back to where he wanted to be, he used to go. Litomakal, I get late for mama ke Arethabeng le papa ke Arethabeng ke batho ba le ne. La ntlhaloganya ke. Oh, erekeleke, let me explain, let me break it down to you. Arethabeng's parents are those people. Yes. And Arethabeng, because of that, Rona as parent, our biggest mistake, we expect for when you are a doctor, you want your son to be a doctor or your child to be a doctor. Ayon is completely wrong. Let's allow children to do what they want, however, but we need to guide them. So Arethabeng, best friends. Haki Molata, the first time when I went to go fetch him, because I didn't know where he was, I got lost, not once, three times. But it was just around the corner. Because I didn't expect Arethabeng to be going there. But Arethabeng taught us that you don't last people. Arethabeng taught us that when you are with those feet, you would fit wherever. You wouldn't even know that Arethabeng is from the U.S. He actually hated that, and people used to enjoy listening to him because he would say, Uncle Tav, you know, these cops, they forever asking me one question because they're listening to me. They're like, you said you're from the States? Yes. And they ask one question and one question, so I get tired of that. All right, let me pass that. One day when I was to take care of Arethabeng by my sister Twin's place and Mr. Lennon's place, I caught Arethabeng stealing. Let me tell you what he was stealing. Millie meal. sugar, and some few other things. And I'm like, big man, what are you doing now? He said, ish, Uncle Thabo, you see where I used to go? There's a family that needs food. And instead of getting angry with him, I said, come on, boy, go ahead and do it. There's nothing wrong with that. Next time, don't steal it. Just tell me that, Uncle Thabo, I'm taking 1, 2, 3. And yesterday, there's a lady that, as I was driving them back to where they're coming from, this lady said to me, you know, I'm going to miss Arethabeng. I said, we are going to miss him. She said to me, you know why? She used to come and say, you staying alone with your son? And the lady would answer, yes. And she said, oh, okay, all right. And Arethabeng could see the situation of that family. So Arethabeng started stealing food from home to feed those who needed it. That's why I said the boy was very special. We didn't understand him until now. That Arethabeng didn't want anything else but to be the person to help the world. Let me tell you, if Arethabeng was a multimillionaire, he would be broke today. If Arethabeng would happen to have 100 million today, by the end of the year, he would be broke. But the good thing is he will know that I enjoyed my money with the families that needed it the most. So that was Arethabeng. So good people, I'm not going to extend and go far because this boy was special. A friend of mine said, Thibos, as I was talking to him, and he was stuttering, and he said, he said, yeah. And he was very intelligent, this guy. And from nowhere, I said to him, you are a premature, right? He said, how do you know that? I said, no, you behave like one. He said, what do you mean? I said, my son stutters, he's a premature. Arethabeng was very smart, he's a premature. And he said, Thibos, what on earth will defeat me if I defeated the womb? Meaning I escaped long before the time. So I'm like, you know you are right. If you manage to escape the womb before your time, nothing will stop you from doing whatever that you wanted to do. This was Arethabeng. Thank you very much, guys. Please, let's celebrate Arethabeng.
And then we believe that he escaped earth prematurely. Exactly the way he entered. Bona, not our place, not our ways, but his ways. We'll never understand, and ours is just to surrender. I would like to now call upon Ali's friends. This young man was kind, was a caring soul. We sure are going to miss him. And as you listen to people who interacted with him, you feel his soul. He gave us everything he had. Everything. I mean, Ali managed to do things that half of you have not even attempted to do. I was sitting with his parents saying, when we look at him, looking at the videos that people are sending us, he's done half the things that we've never even dreamt of doing. He lived. He was here. If you doubt that, I'd like to call upon Mr. Pascal Leping, Ms. Amukhelang Nathani, Ms. Lesedi Molefe, in that order. And if Mrs. Fefe Mowe is here or sends a message, would like to hear that as well, please.
I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. My name is Pascal. As Ari used to call me, Pasky or Pascalito, whichever way he would prefer it. And today I stand before you representing all Ari's friends in South Africa. But before continuing, like any other occasion, we shouldn't continue without touching the Lord scripture. And before continuing, today's dedicated verse talks about how precious time is. The scripture reads as follows. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 to 8. There is a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven. There's a time to be born and there's a time to die. There's a time to plant and there's a time to uproot. There's a time to kill and there's a time to heal. There's a time to tear down and there's a time to build. There's a time to weep and there's a time to laugh. There's a time to mourn and there's a time to dance. There's a time to scatter stones and there's a time to gather them. There's a time to embrace and there's a time to refrain. There's a time to search and there's a time to give up. There's a time to keep and there's a time to throw away. There's a time to tear and there's a time to mend. There's a time to be silent and there's a time to speak. There's a time to love and there's a time to hate. There's a time for war and there's a time for peace. Time is very precious. Time is very precious indeed. Amen. Arethabeng, Ari Lennon. We as our friends are having trouble accepting the fact that you're gone, so we won't. It'll be like we went for a while without seeing each other. We could understand why God wanted you close to him, because you were truly an angel on earth. There's a lot we can share about our friendship. I don't know where to begin. And if I begin, I don't know if I'll ever finish. Because like they say, you lived your life to the fullest. But I believed, we cried and cried, my friend, and our hearts are deeply broken. But they say with time it gets easier. With time it gets easier. We're standing here to bid you farewell to the pearly gates, my friend. Words cannot simply describe how thankful we are for the time you've shared with us. We thank you for the love you gave us. I personally thank you for believing in me again. You were a true, true friend and a brother. I'm thankful for all the time that every time we'd speak on the phone, our last words were always, I love you, my brother. You taught us to love again, and that's very special. We thank you for making us laugh each and every time we got a chance to. We thank you for the time you gave us and the patience. We thank you for not judging us from our backgrounds and nor with our flaws. We thank you for always showing up. You always went the extra mile for everyone. We thank you for vlogging, because today we live to see you, see your beautiful face endlessly. Thank you for creating memories with us. We thank you for showing us to embrace life and live it to the fullest. You took us to your world. As you would always say, we out sizzy, meaning we outside. You always said you were always going to make something shake. And believe you me, this time you really did it. Quote, we bloomed with an angel and we didn't even notice it. But on behalf of your friends, although you're no longer with us physically anymore, in each and every one of us, you will ever be in our hearts, for sure, no cap. And please, while you are weighed in the midst of the Lord, don't forget all your family, friends, and the time you spend in this world. All we left with is now, until we meet again, Brody. Rest in sweet, sweet peace, my guys. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I would like to start off by thanking you for all gathering here today as we celebrate Ari's life. I officially met Ari in 2019 at my little sister's Lesedi's 18th birthday celebration. By then, we had already known of each other, but we didn't really know each other that well. So I was very skeptical when he stood up to give a speech about her because I was just wondering to myself, what was he going to say about her, especially since we all just met 20 minutes ago. To my surprise, he gave the most profound, charming speech about her as if he had known her for a long time. And that's when I realized that he was many things, but acting brand new around new faces and being shy were definitely not part of his characteristics. He had this warmth to him. He was very bubbly and kind and also very welcoming. Truthfully speaking, Ari was a free-spirited person. Arethabeng had this, "I will not be enslaved," unconscious motto that he lived by. He lived his life the way he saw fit for him, and he was happy with every decision he made, and that's something I wish we could all take from him, because we truly never know when it's our turn. Arethabeng lived up to his name. He saw every new person as a potential friend to him, and constantly wanted those around him to be happy despite what he would be dealing with. I don't know how he did that, but he always managed to put other people first.
Ari was a lovable person. Yes, he could be very annoying at times, but that's exactly what I'll miss about him. Him just annoying me and the simplest things are like him telling me how his day was. On August the 7th, I lost a friend, a brother. He was a straight shooter, and that's something I deeply admired about him. Simply put, he was a gift. There are no words, just tears to describe how hard the future will be without him. He has left behind an aching mother trying to find comfort in the arms of equally an aching father, and he has also left behind siblings who are crushed to the core. I still long to talk to him every day. I listen to the voice recordings he left me and laugh or cry at what he recorded. His authenticity and love were his guiding force. His absence has been felt deeply down in my soul. As heartbreaking and painful today may be, let us rejoice and also live up to his name the way he would wanted us to. To Ari, thank you for showing me that someone I met 3 years ago can make a huge impact in my life as opposed to someone I've met 10 years ago. You are gone way too soon, and I look forward to the day I will see you again. Rest easy, my brother. I love you. You fought so well. You inspired many. You loved so deeply. You lived so loudly. And no one that ever knew you can ever forget you. Arethabeng, I know I will never will. Enjoy your rest in glory. I will see you when I get there. With a broken heart, I will celebrate your life. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I want to extend my gratitude to all the relatives, friends, and attendees who have come today to honor and celebrate Ari. Ari is one of the bravest people I know. He not only has the best sneaker game, dripped in Jordans 24/7, and don't forget to mention his Ralph Lauren collection, but also he has an infectious enthusiasm and contagious laughter that carried out to the last moments of his life. It pains me each day knowing that you were borrowed from me for a short time, but I'm grateful to say that you touched each and every person's heart. You were not only a generous soul, always eager to give back, but a lovable character who always knew how to lift one's spirit, offer sound advice, and perform selfless acts. I would just like to say that today is not a commemoration, but rather a celebration of Ari's life. Because Ari lived a fulfilled life. You lived your life to the fullest, man. I mean, you were outside, like you would always say. With a fearless and altruistic personality, I'm grateful to have known you for this time in my life, because you too have showed me how to be fearless and to stand up for others. I read a poem that stuck with me, and I'd like to share it. Those we love don't go away. They walk beside us every day. Unseen, unheard, but always near. Still loved, still missed, and very dear. I ask that we all take with us all of the amazing memories and qualities Ari shared with us, that we live life to the fullest and give back as graciously as he did. Share the love that Ari always gave, and that we too can be as happy as he was. To end this speech, I'm going to read a Bible verse. Matthew 11, verse 29 to 30. Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle at heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy to bear, and the burden I give you is light. Ari, you fought so well. You inspired so many. You loved so deeply. You lived so loudly. And no one that ever knew you can ever forget you. I love you, Ari. May you rest in paradise. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Fefe Mue on the program. You know, coming here, I had this whole speech written, but I think I'm just going to speak from the heart and talk about my relationship with Ari and how he was a little brother to me. Ari and I first met when we were very young. I still remember attending his parents' wedding. And later on, we got a bit older, him living overseas, us being here. We reconnected again, and I went to visit Ari and spend the summer with his family in Charlotte. Ari and I then decided to take a road trip with another friend of his. And we went to Miami, we went to Atlanta, and we had the time of our lives. We had wild times, you know, and I'd say we did a lot of mischievous things together. You know, those memories I hold dear to my heart because I got so close to him in such a short time, and I found Ari to be such a genuine, authentic person. He never pretended for anyone. He never held back, but he was still respectful, and he carried himself like the gentleman he was. Ari represented both his parents well by the way he treated the elderly to the youngest kids. We did a lot of things together that I could say in a short time that I never experienced with even the friends I had for the longest time. And the best time to get to know someone is when you're traveling on the road with them. We had our ups and downs, but we always loved each other. And I'd like to thank Mama Nintavi and Uncle Tony for raising such a beautiful, genuine, smart boy. And I'm just glad that I got to spend time with him for the time he did have on this earth. And I feel honored to have met someone like him than not have met him at all, because he was a blessing in my life. Thank you.
Hallelujah, we bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I once heard some guy from KZN, a big guy. He was present worshiping, but I heard what he meant. And he said, Amazulu, Atembelona, Kantinati, Tembelona, the heavens. Amazulu, Atembelona, Kantinati, Tembelona, ay. Amazulu, Atembelona, Kantinati, Tembelona, Wangi Paka Misa, Wangi Paka Misa, Wangi Paka Misa, Wangi Paka Misa, Wangi Wangi paka misa wangi akwayete wangi pa kamisa ay agare and that is the reason I see an Aisha Fuji abuja moholo kwane. And that is the reason I see an Asha 4G scammed. Wangi pa kamisa wangi pa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Kamisa. Agoyet. Wangi pa kamisa. Wangi paga, whoa, wangi, whoa, whoa. Hey, we are celebrating, and that is the reason I see an Asha for Jesus, Jesus, hey. And that is the reason I sing for Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, I come back. Oh, ingako, gikula, gisage, gobu chesu. Ay, 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 ay. Wo ingako gikula kitabe kongu chesu eh oh wo wangi paka misa wangi paga misa wangi paga wo ay Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Nakikupa ulibulela something. as black people, I'm not even going to say African people, because other African states don't do what we do. The reason you get depressed 50 months later after losing a loved one, Renali Milau, I don't know who wrote Milau, that how tokofaletwi, you must just be sobi, and we're celebrating a life well lived. We are here to celebrate a son of God who came here, honored his assignment, and now he's no more. Liba utwile banaba, are you touched? What are we going to say when you are no more? Please don't make us lie. Live your life in such a way that we will find words to describe who you were to us. These kids were not lying. You could see the authenticity, because that's how he touched their lives. Ari lived a brilliant, blessed life. And we thank the parents. You did a stunning job raising a responsible, loved, lovable young man. At a time when young men are beating up women, killing women, young men are troubled because they don't know how to connect to their emotions. But you raised a responsible, brilliant, beautiful young man who was caring and loving. And today we're celebrating that life. So maybe you came here and you thought you were coming to a funeral. Let me just awaken you, because Brad Johnny and his gang are going to get you revived. You are not going to be the same again when you leave here. As we move right along, would like now to call upon family, friends, and I will start with Mr. Botsang Muilwa, followed by Dodo Molefe, in that order. They are family, friends. DJ, can we bring them with a hymn, please?
Who speaks too much. I never lack weight. I never run out of weight. But I'm out of weight. You know, when I walked in here, I was expecting sobbing minds, sobbing faces, crying and screaming. But what I've prepared last night is well befitting. When I see and I listen to youngsters singing and dancing and ulating and celebrating a life of a young great man, then I know he got it. And there's nothing better than this. You know, Tony, my brother, no man wants to bury his son. Our kids are supposed to bury us. When a samurai falls, and gives the katana, he gives it to the son, to can carry the flag of the family up front. We are sitting and standing here this morning, painfully sending away one of our sons. I can never relate. I'm a father of sons and daughters. I can never relate to what you, Tabiseng, and family members are going through to send the sweetest one away. The saddest part is he was the most, you know, my mom described Ari as the humble one. And I used to say to my mom, he probably took from the dead, not from the mother. And I will be very short, I won't be long. And you can't talk too long with a short-lived life. But let me tell you and depart from what Christians always say, that Mudimu une arifele jano uwile otere. I want to depart from that statement. God didn't give us a son and took the son. The evil, the devil, took the son of God to go and test the faith of Ari to God. Let us hope and believe that the way his parents and the community at large and the nations have brought him up, it will save him against the evil influences of God. And he continues to give light to those who are full here and following on his footsteps. I am not going to sit here and talk long like I will usually do with a lively short, but the little we have learned from him, the humbleness. One thing that I take with me, he was a very humble child. And that is what I'm taking with me. And to all other kids, you must see how this boy had respected his parents. The respect he commanded to his parents, whether they were absent, whether they were in a distance, it happened so many times that we'll be on a telephone call, video call with him, whether in the country and they are out or they are in and he's out, and he will show respect and humbleness. And that's what I take with me on that. Rest in peace, son of the soil. And we hope that your faith in the creator of mankind will keep your parents' heart happy for the rest of their lives. I thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Life is pleasant. Death is peaceful. It's the transition that's troublesome. Life, unfortunately, means there has to be death. It is inevitable. And as much as we hate losing those special people from our lives, we have to come to terms with it. The two hardest things to say in life are hello for the first time and goodbye for the last time. Only in the agony of parting do we look into the depths of love. But we can find comfort and support in our friends, family, and loved ones. However, we still have to find our own way to say goodbye to those who pass away. It was last year, September, when you, Ari, came to our home. You were welcomed in our home for the period you stayed with us. From your parents, I remember your mom saying, "Oh no, this wasn't the plan," because Ari landed through the kitchen door from the US to our kitchen door. I remember your mom being very worried how you got to Lanseria when they knew you to be with your uncle, Uncle Tabo. What a pleasant time to get to know this young man. The whole family fell in love with him simply because of his authenticity. Ari was exactly how his mom described him to me before I met him. On the day when Ari came, the mom spoke in fast forward, because she was scared. She was just so bothered. How did Ari get to Lanseria? She said, "Oh, don't worry about Ari. Ari is respectful, loving, caring, super." She was going on fast because she was still in shock that how did she land? Yeah, super. So these descriptions, she said to me in fast forward, probably the second she mentioned, so I'm going to go slowly so that you can hear each and every description of our child. Ari is respectful, loving, caring, super intelligent, hard worker, a good kid. He loves to clean. He can even do dishes. These are the words of the mom. He cooks. He is very clean. He loves children. He can massage you if you have pain. He loves life. He is fun. His famous brand is Ralph Lauren. Yes, and he has chronic asthma, but stable, though at times it can spark an attack unprovoked. We as a family found that to be true, or even more of what how the mom described Ari. What an amazing soul this young man was. My children loved him deeply. He made time to have simple to deep conversations with each one of them. What an impactful young man. It's not even a year since we knew him, but we experienced his inner soul just in less than a year. We had episodes of attending to him when he had critical asthma attacks and visits to hospitals. Uncle Tabo was my partner there. Sometimes even when the mom is here. We had fun trips with him and enjoyed his company. And him being a free-spirited soul, we had conversations about his future according to our human eyes. We wanted him to do what we knew and what we thought he needed to do in this life. Little did we know, little did we understand that all Ari was about was to touch humanity uniquely, to teach us to understand how to love, how to be simple and still be happy, how to beat our daily struggles with love and compassion. Ari, I just want to tell you that now we know. We have taken those green leaves from your beautiful tree of life, which is your soul, and we'll take it further as an extension of who you are. I'm still talking to Ari in present tense. I still can't say was. And what you stood for in life. We see in Psalm 139 verse 2 that Ari's life was amazing and approved by the Lord. Psalm 139 verse 2 says, "You know my down-sitting and my uprising. You understand my thoughts are far off." And Psalm 139 verse 3, "You sift and search out my path and my laying down, and you are acquitted with all my ways." So we need not judge, but try to understand deeply. This clearly shows that he is and was in God's plan for his life. He didn't miss it. We did. We sometimes lack understanding of him. We are taught from young that God is love. Where God is, there is love. I can strongly say that Ari loved the way our Father loved each and every one of us. And that's one of the lessons or one of the leaves most of us will take from him. You are a man who fought a lot of battles, but just like all of us did, but you fought with a smile and humility. Because of your love, compassion, utmost respect for humanity, you won in life. You've gained so many friends who all love you dearly. You've brought us here today to celebrate your life, even when it hurt so deep. Your life was never short. No, it wasn't. You lived it all according to the way you saw fit. All your days were numbered by the Lord. Psalm 139 verse 16 says, "Your eyes saw my unformed substance, and in your book all the days of my life were written, before ever they took shape, when as yet there was none of them." Ari, you live them all according to the word. Goodbye, son. As he would call me, Mama D. You are a role model for everyone. You will stay in our hearts forever. To Ari's family, may the love you share in the family and the love of friends comfort you during these difficult times. My most heartfelt condolences, or our most heartfelt condolences as a family. In closing, it is sad when the person who gave you beautiful, special memories become your RIP. A great soul serves everyone all the time. And that's what Ari did. A great soul never dies. It brings us together again and again. That's Maya Angelou's quote. When someone you love becomes a memory, his memory becomes a treasure. We will treasure your memories in our hearts. Ari, we wish you farewell in your journey to eternity. You will never be forgotten. Rest in peace, Ari. Our prayers and fond memories are what we have to remember you. Rest in eternal glory, dearest son.
Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes,
the piano guy is always late. Next time, please tell him what song we're on so that he can catch on. Thank you. Thank you very much to the family members. And that was heartfelt. And we appreciate your words of comfort. And as we can tell, Ari was a bright light to the world. If you still haven't caught on, parents, you did well. You did very well. And it takes a village to raise a child. And Ali's testament to exactly that, as we see more and more young and old testifying on who this young man was. I think it was Pascal who was talking about the legacy that he's left. And I'd like to add, on top of the respect that you talk about, Ali was love. He was just so loving. And because he was loved by his parents. So, love your children. Love your children. Because when you don't love them, they seek love in all wrong places. This one knew that I'm loved by my parents. And you know, I think it was Mr. Muilwa who was talking about the respect always when he's speaking to his parents. And you teach them. Teach them young, that which you teach them is exactly what it is that they're going to live out in public. So let's add those ingredients. I'd like to now call upon Mr. Mandla, Mandla Hamka, who is co-founder of Proud Fathers. Yeah, I don't want to Englishify a Xhosa surname. Mandla Hamka, who is co-founder of Proud Fathers. Who's also a family friend, and he will be followed by Mr. Mzi Kumalo, PEC member of the African National Congress, who is in this region, who is here to also pay his tribute. And as they come, I'd like to hand over to Joni and gang to do us proud.
Yeah. One of my competencies is come 17. Give free and fair. Now let's go abroad. Yeah, Ari. God is able to do. That's what he said. He will do. God is able. Ari. Oh, 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 he's able. Ha ha ha. Oh, 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 he hey, come on again. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I can see them, you're doing that. Hey, hey. Oh, 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 oh. He's able. I was again. Whoa, oh, 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 my friends. Oh, 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 okay. Oh, he's able, okay. He's able, he's able, he's able, he's able, he's able, he's able, oh, oh, hi, yeah, yeah. Oh, I'm celebrating the young man. Woo. Oh. Come on now. Woo.
Dumelan, dumelan, le guy. Then, ikamala mumanda ham, indo te balle gile lam sabino kula wanga matota. Umanda co-founded Portfathers ngamba no sampi. Yes, started Portfathers 2013. Ngoba besibona ukuthi kunodingo lokuthi sizi community sizana nabo baba. And then Ari sebenze no Ari kakhulu si re understand Ari thata le rona ke ba tlo leboga modimo gore na re kadimile Ari ke ba tlo leboga DDT ke ba tlo leboga o Sinthabi gore ba re ka khone gore kadima Ari re berekile Ari thata ne re khona go tswa go pentela batho di ntlo re tsamalene Ari le Musa and no bona le mo gore ntho a go fana e mo pelong ya gagwe. And come to German, okay, I go to Colon or distribute body uniform, Nerzamalene Ari, and there's Hangata, Nerbergalene, got December, and no one or Lily December, Gau Tarazabo, Ariali December, Babatahua Stratting, Mare Ariga December, Obaton Nale Proud Fathers. Why is your Mosevitu a hot lady Molefatsing? Arina is your ene Atla Fella Molefatsing. Naijo ene tshwantse a thatshe dipelo tsa batho ka re ntho re tletse mo lefatseng batho ba bangata ba itse re tletse go ngwala mabitso a rona ko dipelong tsa batho. Yes, a re na tletseng ntho eo and ka itumela gore le ka Christmas na ba kgone go tla o Sinthabi a tlo mothopa ka bo 80 phakela ba tsamaya o ga kena mme go tla go nna le bo di 10 kg tsa kgogo then a re arene o tla etsa kgogo after moo nna nna busy ne re sa mlelele le sampiro a re etsa 1 2 3 next then after moo o tla tshola there's one time ka go nna ka fetsa sekolo ke ne ka dosa ko sekolong there's one time re bile a ba fetsa go ja bana ba be re ba di ice cream yana a batla go nna re uncle mandla do the scooping sampi a re mpleletseng thweng ke ntho it came for to a remora telambana about ice cream and Arina understand that one about Carabatola ice cream, Navata Bata by Pinde Arian Zabafa by 2 million two. And after Mohai leave the party pack, Aruta Bafa, Ajavele one, Arina Lea, Nalerato, Ebeno Tando, O Aribu Tando. Kai 2 minutes given the cousins are really Banavo and Zababu and Kitumel Gauli Walegamudim. The important Ronanum for youth Kimudim. Regabua Lutos or let's say in little fats. Marmudim Gene Chanta. Kil would really work at the script digger Lebutale. The next generation Arona, it on a right. I'll Rona Banabacana, Bacono Guaramudim. As La Seganga. As la seganga ke lebogile thata le mo diperenseng se godisitseng bana ba ka go ka utlwa ba bua phela the leaders to the next generation ba utlwa ka go bua wa utlwa lantse ba bua gone a ga latlhega le gona lantse re kula mebile bo sampi a tshwere ke watwat o tla ya go bone ba le mo fodisa re lebogile thata le ya no sampane re bua le sampere a re ureditse proud o reditse proud le ka di kila na le 24 tsa December re allo distributor di tlhako tse more than 200 re na le ari fo bona ba sokolang re na le ari and lena itumetse and ari nthwene re rata ga sampi na satate ka go bona bongata ba tata go ima ke batlo tsama I want to call my mom o batla bo di bega na sa batle bo di bega ha re fetse o etsa mosebetsi gore tlo walker from ko re tswang teng re ya ko gae ga re fitlha ko gae ke mo watlo founelang thabo go thabo tlo molata ke lebogile thata and ke ya kopa go kopa le gape le family ya the Lennons and re sa tla fela mo funeraleng then after mo besetse go fedile ngoba o mosebenzi o sa qhobeka kopa re dule ntse re bakenya mo dithapelong la romela nthabiseng o le friend age mo romele message wa o monate unkulunkulu sa sithanda sonke o ari sithashile nathi I port for us as correct mazuba right ngoba sithemba unkulunkulu ke a leboga thata inkosi.
Good morning, Dumelang. Bitso la ka ke Mzikhumalo. On behalf of the African National Congress in Gauteng Province, kindly accept our condolences. Now, I have been sitting there and asking myself, what is it that I'm going to say? Because it does appear that quite a number of things in our country are not going well. Everything seems to be falling apart. But once I heard Omalume speaking here, and once I heard the friends of Ari speaking here, I immediately said there's future in our country, and there's hope in our country. And what is the message that I picked up from the life well lived? The message is one, do not accept the status quo. And I think that's what Ari was telling us, because if you accept the status quo, you're running a risk of where we are now, wherein the country looks like it's going to collapse anytime. It's because we accepted the status quo. So Ari did not accept even to stay in the home of his mother for only 9 months. He refused. Because he doesn't want to confine and accept the status quo. And I think that's the message that he is sending to many of us, particularly his peers. He became a global citizen at a very young age. I'm sure he's done quite a lot of traveling alone. Not even seeking your guidance or details of where he's going, because he was a global citizen. That on its own represent a young man who wanted to break all the barriers, including not accepting the status quo. I hear from the friends that he did quite a number of things. He cared of the poor, which is what many of us are failing to do. He, despite his social standing, associated himself with the most poorest within this community that he was living in. He gave us hope. As I say, part of his work was to ensure that we don't accept the status quo. I always say, when I talk to young people, who taught us that ours is to go to school, ours is to go to institution of higher learning, get all the knowledge, skills, and information required. Then we come back and we have to work for somebody. Who taught us that? Isn't it that this is time that we break all of those barriers? And I think that's what I am learning from Ari's life. In my world, people do not die. In my world, people just pass on. And I know, standing in front of you, that Ari will always be with us. He will always guide you, his friends. He will always ensure that you share the dream, the vision that he had, not only for himself, but for the entire country. So we're saying to you as a family, whilst this represents a loss, but take it from us. This is not a loss. Ari will always live with us and will ensure that we live his dream. And I want to ask particularly the youngsters, please live his life. Break all the barriers. Do not accept the status quo, for that's what he was standing for. Thank you very much, Program Director.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mzi Khumalo, on behalf of the African National Congress. And I remember interviewing Mr. Hamka, even on air I said Hamka, and he didn't correct me. thank you for standing for something, because if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. Sure, this is a moment, man. This young man lived. He left permanent footprints in our souls, in our hearts. And I'd like right now to call upon his aunt, Auntie Ladona, who is going to read his obituary, because when the parents give right of reply, there might not be a tear left and we might not pay attention. I'm yet to find an obituary that's so beautifully written. I mean, this guy lived beautifully. Even his obituary is so befitting. And I could hear him say, I got this. We're going to help you stand with a song before we do this. So please hit us up, DJ.
Dumilan and good morning. Arethabeng Anthony Lennon was born on March 20, 1997 in Pretoria, South Africa. On August 7, 2022, Ari was called home by the angel of the Lord to rest and share in God's glorious kingdom. He was in South Africa where his life began. He was raised in Baltimore, Maryland in the United States. He attended Deer Park Elementary School. Ari was an outstanding student as well as excelling in many sports, including basketball, football, soccer, and baseball. In 2007, upon moving to Charlotte, North Carolina, Ari attended Ridge Road Middle School and Mallard Creek High School. Upon his graduation in 2015, he attended North Carolina Agricultural and Technical University. After attending university, Ari pursued various careers, including human resources, office management. His last position was the director of administration for Kanyang Group, where he performed many key roles and responsibilities. His efforts were invaluable to the company, and he will be sorely missed. Ari was deeply committed to serving the community. He spent many hours serving in nonprofit organizations and particularly fond of tutoring, mentoring students, as well as providing jobs to many, always willing to share his time freely. Ari dedicated to giving back to anyone he found in need. As an avid traveler, a foodie, and a fashionable dresser, he loved Ralph Lauren, organizer, and enjoyed partying big time. He was the life of the party. He loved South African Amapiano music. He made everyone feel good and was full of compassion. Ari was incredibly generous, and he was a philanthropist of note. His favorite line was, "I got you."
Yeah.
I wish I could sing. And at this moment, as I call upon my friends, the parents of Arethabeng, Anthony Jr. Lennon, I'd like to share these words as I call upon his parents, that it's sometimes hard to know why some things happen as they do. For so much joy and happiness was centered around this young man. It seems so hard to comprehend that you're no longer here, Arethabeng. But all the happy memories will help keep you near our hearts. You are thought about with so much pride. With each mention of your name, we take so much pride. And death cannot change a single thing about you. We love you always. Shall we stand as we allow the parents to come and share with us? But I think they need a song with a vavavum. Because we're celebrating a life, remember? I think let's give Johnny a chance.
Whoopi, dukuselu moya wa. Baba mina gizoha hamba. Chonge. Aguka moholugwane moholugwane timomo timomo mo 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 goba mina ho ha amba
amba ni
jonge ai
Amen. So we were advised to either write and have somebody read or make a voice note and have it read. You know, it's our son. It was almost like, where do you even begin? What do you say? So I made a recording that I planned on playing. So you all can share with me
and this deep, deep pain is the mother I'm feeling right now. My husband and I were invited somewhere by our friends for dinner. It was three couples. And I was thinking, you know, we were living it, looking good, ready to go party. And we were. Had a nice bottle of wine. Those who know me, you know I like my wine. We're driving about 45 to 50 minutes to our friend's house. We get in, we laugh, we take pictures. It's airy, still summer in America. So, you know, we're feeling good, ready for dinner, play games, and just as couples, you know, interact. Then I get a call from Mrs. Natani. She didn't say anything. A mother always knows. Okay, let me say it again. A mother always knows. I had this cut run through my womb. And remember, our son has had asthma since he was 9 months old. I always said he was a doctor himself, because he knew how to take care of himself. He's been in the ICU when we travel. We're a family that travels a lot. When we were in Europe for the jazz festival, and the doctor called his father and they couldn't get us. We were flying back to the US. And as soon as we landed in New York, we turned the phones on and there was a message on his phone to say, Mr. Lennon, this is Dr. So-and-so. We need you to call us ASAP. In fact, come straight to the hospital. Do you know we didn't go home? We went straight to the hospital where our son was. I swear I thought that was it. He had tubes all over him. He was almost gone then. He was in a coma. Well, the hospital had to do it so they can treat him because he was so far gone. But let me tell you, this thing right here always reminded us that you can die from anywhere you are. Death can find you anywhere you are. Doesn't matter if you're under the bed. And let me tell you, Ari truly knew more than so many of us, including myself. Because Ari was right. Ari was in the hospital when his spirit went to the other side. The hospital, we expect, right? I mean, it doesn't happen that way all the time. But we expect that when you go to the hospital, you get help, right? And remember, we already have a history with him going to the hospital. But Ari was right. It does not matter where you are. Death will find you anywhere. You can't run from it. One of our neighbors who came to comfort us yesterday said, the 100 years and the 100 years of work that God gave Ari, Ari figured, you know what, I'm going to compress all these into 25 years. I got something to, you know, somewhere to go. You all stay over here and do what you do, but I'm out. I'm out. And one of his aunts sent a beautiful message, long. You know, South Africans, we're known to be long-winded. And I think, Kanye, the words that I remember is that Ari, rest well, son. God knew. That's why he got your parents together. Their love for each other runs so deep. They will be okay, Ari. Don't worry about them. Just rest well. We were a family that was not ashamed to show love. My husband and I show love at any time. I remember both our sons one day saying to us, we were sitting outside, remember? Outside on the porch. This one you're talking about, I'm never gonna get married. I'm like, what? No, we get married over here. He's like, yeah, but I don't think I can find love like you all. I'm like, you will. You will, Dyson. And I prayed for my kids to one day be blessed with good women. That's what every parent wants, right? And then what's next? Grandkids. And then you make these grand plans, guys. My husband and I work very hard, you know, in planning and building some more. And that's one thing that Ari was taking. Ari was being groomed to run these businesses. But God said, no, there's another one. There are others. Ari can start, but Ari won't be here to see the finish. There are others that will take over. Ari went and hired 10 guys, 10. From, as so many have said, a place we didn't expect. Not only did he do that, he would take them to work every single morning, 6 o'clock in the wintertime, cold. And then he will bother me about, Mom, you know, they work so hard, they need money to eat. I'm like, Ari, really? They're getting paid. They can buy lunch. He's like, but Mom, I mean, you know, they're using all their strength and there's so much work. Like, Ari made sure that I fall in his ideas that you got to take care of people. I love that about my son. Ari was blessed because both his grandparents were givers. My mother-in-law was a giver. My mother-in-law and my father-in-law, they would take people. I remember my sister-in-law sharing with me that on Christmas days, they would not only cook and go feed those who didn't have, but they would bring them in the house. I remember Ari, Lord, I had to call my sister-in-law in Texas. I said, Donna, I don't know what to do, but your nephew here is coming with some stuff. No, it was you. Right, it was you. It was Dyson. Dyson brought us this girl and her mama, talk about they don't have a place to stay. Can they come stay with us? I'm like, what? Who does that? We don't know them. I called Donna. I said, Donna, what do I do? I don't know these people. I don't want to sleep and, you know, worry if we're going to get stabbed or whatever. I don't know these people. And Donna said, well, Tabby, let me tell you. If you remember, that's what your mother-in-law used to do. And Lenny and I, that's Donna's husband, Lenny and I do it. You know, we cook and we take food. So talk to God. Remember you said that? You said pray about it. Ask God to give you a light, whether to do it or not to do it. And I did, right when we got off the phone. And in my heart, whether it was God talking to me or, you know, whatever. But I told him, I said, they can come. And they came, and they stayed with us. They ate with us. And we took their daughter to work, you know, using our cars, go pick her up from work. I mean, we did all of that. So what my kids have is spirit of giving. My mother had that too, the other grandparents. She was a giver. She was known. She will give the last shirt on her body. My mother did not give, Pastor, where are you? My mother did not give 10%. She did not do that. It wasn't tithing to her. My mother would even give 50% of her salary. Like, really? Who does that? Your mother. So what Ari did, it was nothing that was not done in our family. It's something that we practice. He just took it a notch up. And Ari, has left us with the gift of so many families that we absolutely love. I understand now that family is not blood. Blood will disappoint you, if anything. Blood won't show up, if anything. But you will have those that God gave you along the way of life that will be there every time of the way. All these beautiful friends that Ari have, every single one of them say one thing. They talk of Ari's giving nature. They talk of Ari's love. I said it. Ari didn't have love. He was love. So you couldn't help but receive some of that love because he was love. And by the way, his name. Let's be happy. Wherever Ari was, oh, it was some fun. It was some fun. I mean, Mama loves fun too, but Ari is on another level. Ari was blessed with the most loving father, caring. I hope I'm not taking your speech away, honey. But let me just share this. One day, Ari, his father used to travel with work. On Mondays, I would take him to the airport. He would fly to different cities in the U.S. And then he'd come home on Thursdays. Dyson and I would be sitting, or rather standing, on top of the stairs as Daddy came. And Ari would be the one running down those stairs as soon as he hears the door, you know, ready to open. And he'll be the first one to welcome his father. Yeah, we're just sitting there. Then Dyson will follow, you know, as the big brother. And then, of course, Mama. So one day, his father went to Seattle, I think. And Ari got sick. I took him to the emergency room. They tried to help him breathe. They struggled. They didn't have enough oxygen for him. And I overheard the nurses say that, oh, he's in trouble. We need to move him to our children's hospital downtown Charlotte. And Ari, I mean, I just couldn't imagine overhearing this and his father's not here. His brother is in school. I'm alone at the hospital. So I immediately called him. He didn't pick up. He was still on air. When he landed, he called me to tell me he landed. I said, did you listen to the message? He said, no, I was trying to call you first to let you know that I'm here. When I told him that your son is so sick that they had to call, is it called a a helicopter. He was transported by a helicopter from where we stay in Charlotte to downtown Charlotte to the children's hospital to be put in the ICU. Let me tell you, my husband made a U-turn right there at the airport. He took the next flight out and came straight to the hospital. This man here stayed with his son in the hospital for the entire week. He slept with his son. He woke up with him. The doctors even started wondering, what does he do for a living that allows him to be in the hospital? I will go home and sleep sometimes. And he'll say to me, that's fine, baby, I got this. Well, he must have gotten that to him. I'm just, look, I just thought about that. Yes, he said, I got this. Go home and get some rest, and then I'll go home, rest, come back fresh, and bring in some clothes and some food, and he's still sitting there. So guys, let me just make one thing clear. Ari was loved. Ari, the love that he was given, he also shared it with others. Ari has taught us so much. Ari used to keep me in check, respectfully so, because, you know, I went to him to complain. Yes, sometimes I do. Like, Ari, you know, so-and-so, I can't believe they did that. Ari was like, Mom, you know, you did your part. It's okay, you did your part. Leave it alone, Mom. Before we went back home, it's been a while. because, you know, their father was a coach, basketball coach, and he coached all of them. Before we went back to the U.S., because some of you remember, we were just here not long ago celebrating my husband's birthday. And Ari said to his father, they're both wearing robes, gowns. And Ari said, Dad, let's go watch a movie. It hasn't happened in so long. And I was so happy. Every mother wants that. You know, you want your children and their dads to be close and to play together and to cook together and to learn together and to do things together. And he said, Dad, let's go watch a movie. And my husband said, babe, did you hear that? Sure, I better run right now before he changes his mind. And he left me upstairs and went downstairs, sat there with his son, and they watched a movie. And of course, I had to capture that moment, right? I came running downstairs with the phone, shooting a video, like, hey guys, hey guys. They're like, hey, hey. I come downstairs, I come to them. I was like, wait a minute. Are you shooting us or you're doing a selfie? I'm like, selfie. Guys, I don't know. Right now, I'm not crying. I have my episodes. I'm not trying to be strong, but I'm not crying. I'm not. We slept with our son, my husband and I. And I reminded him, I said, remember when he was a baby, when we used to sleep on your single bed? Those who read my book know that single bed. I said, remember we used to sleep with him on a single bed? We get to sleep with him on this side of the earth one more time. And when we went to bed, we said, good night, boy, we love you. And this morning, we said, good morning, sweet thing. Today you get to be laid, but you will forever, remain in our hearts, because you were special. You are ours. Rest well, son of the soil. Rest well, my baby. Rest well, my son. Rest well, my heart. Rest well, my seed. Rest. It is well. You lived, Ari. And I promise you, Daddy and I, and Dyson, and your nephews and nieces, we are going to carry your torch, honey. The work you have started, we're going to continue it. You best believe. Mommy loves you.
Good morning, everyone. My voice is kind of weak today. Is going to come that you your children, but you're here. I spent the whole week trying to prepare a speech to say about Ari, and tonight it came to me that I just needed to give some reflections as a father. Um, And I remember from early when he was one, not even 2 years old, the only thing he loved to do was go outside, run down the street, and play with all of his friends. Sometimes when we may be out, we would come back, he would hide from us, so he didn't have to go in the house. You know, he was a man of the people. You know, he loved making friends. Ari never made, he never made enemies. He had some remarkable qualities. I remember when he was at UC, he loved the Lakers, his favorite team. Kobe Bryant was his favorite player. And from the age of five, I think, to about 12, I coached him in basketball. He played other sports, but I coached him in basketball. We're a basketball family. And he wasn't the best player, and he was probably the smallest on the team, but he had a lot of heart. And you knock him down, he gets back up, he's diving on the floor. And you know, I was trying to mold him as a player, and I would, you know, try to teach him to be a leader. And I would say, you know, sometimes you have to shoot the ball. And he would always, almost every time, refrain from shooting and pass it to his teammates, because he wanted to see his teammates succeed. But I think, to me, his most remarkable quality was, I remember he was about 9 or 10, and he would take the bus to school. He was in middle school, and there was a boy in our neighborhood who, for whatever reason, he would bully Ari. And so one day, Ari, he chased him from the school bus. Ari ran. He ran somewhere, was hiding, and called his mother. And she came and rescued him, so to speak. So about 2 weeks later, this little boy, and I was a bit annoyed, you know. So 2 weeks later, this little boy comes to the house, and he's looking, knocking on the door. He says, "Is Ari home?" And I'm thinking to myself, "What are you doing at my house, boy? What did you just do to my son?" And I called Ari. I said, "Ari, why is he here?" He said, "Oh, he's my friend, Dad." I said, "What? He's your friend?" But that's how he was. He never held grudges. He looked at everybody as a friend. I remember later when he was in high school, he would, from time to time, come in my office, and we would sit down and talk for maybe an hour, sometimes more. And mostly he listened, and you know, occasionally he talked, and we would talk about his friends, and he would say, "Yeah, Dad, that's my best friend." And then a little later on, "Oh yeah, Dad, this is my best friend." Maybe five people. And I said, "Ari, how can you have all these best friends?" He's like, "Dad, you can have more than one best friend." I never heard of that. So this is a tough day. We shed a lot of tears, and we're going to shed a lot more, but it is a celebration, and I'm honored that all of you could come out and celebrate Ari's life with us. There's a lot more that I can say, but I think I'm going to cut the story short, because I'll be going all day. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. I'm Ari's big brother. One thing my father didn't tell you about that story was I had to go chase the boy down. But Ari always Ari always annoyed people, and I felt like I had to protect him. But he would always say, I just kill him with kindness. Yeah. And I never understood that because I wasn't like that. Yeah. I was the angry kid. I was the one that always wanted to fight for Ari. Yeah. For myself as well. But I never understood where Ari got his kindness from, where he got his compassion from. I never understood it. And only until I had my own son, who acts just like Ari, annoys me so much. But I love him, and it's just something about Ari that just resonates with you. And my heart is broken. I lost my little brother, but he's not gone. I don't need to protect him. That's what he always told me. You don't have to protect me. You don't need to protect me. So I'm not protecting him anymore. I'm gonna let him kill everybody with kindness, or as he would say, just throw his kindness out to the world. He can make you so mad and smile on your face. He could do that. He could really do that. I can't. I still can't understand that. But that's Ari. Everybody who really knows Ari knows you will love him and be aggravated with him in the same breath. That's Ari. He loves. That's just Ari. That's just Ari. But I just wanted to say, he's the most compassionate person, the most loving person I've ever known. And this doesn't have to be a sad moment. This doesn't have to be. Ari wouldn't want anybody to be sad. Ari would be laughing at me right now if I was crying, annoying me right now. I could feel him doing it. So it's not sad. It's not a sad moment. This is a rejoiceful moment. Ari is happy. Ari is happy. Ari is happy. Everybody who knows him, who came to see Ari, is happy. This is something Ari would want. Everybody to turn up for him. Yeah. Everybody to be there for. Ari is a people person. Yeah. This is what Ari would want. Ari loves people. So everybody who's here, thank you. I appreciate y'all coming.
How about DJ? Tabising and Papa Anthony and Big Bro Dustin, thank you. Thank you for this opportunity to having shared our lives with a handsome, graceful, loving Lakers fan with
comforted in knowing that he found Kobe Brown. He did. He continues to teach, and he continues to kill them with kindness. A lesson all of us can learn. Came, he loved, he served. Very respectful man. He was there. And I guess the challenge is now with us. The bigger challenge is with the pastor right now. Because he only had 10 minutes to summarize his sermon. I tried to convince you for me, right? I really tried. And I once again would want to remind you that 14 days we live for the Lord. If we die for the Lord. The way that we live and die, we belong to the Lord. He belongs to the Lord. He's the Lord right now. I brought endless love and joy to this world. We'll always remember him when he say, I got you.
Family and all friends and relatives and all who are here, we take this time to greet all in the precious name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord for this day and we give thanks to him for such an important day in the life of the family, Lennon family, and we are seated here and we are looking at them, where they are so cheerful, and we are saying, as all of us who are here, we really have no reason to make them cry, because already they are so cheerful. Amen. We want to thank the Lord, beloved, that we are also here. It is an opportunity that we so much appreciate to stand in front of this family at such an important time. Then we are saying, as we hear the stories about the young men here, wow, what a life. What a life. And I'm reminded the man who cried out and said, let me die the death of a righteous man, and let my end be like him. And I'm saying, yes, we are all here. Death brings a time of reflection, a time of thinking. His mother said, this is a reminder that death will get you wherever you are. There are three things that man does not know. That is when he will die, how he will die, and where he will meet death. But that is a certainty, because it is appointed unto man to die once, and after that, the judgment. Hallelujah. We want to thank God for Ari. He truly, as one of the poets said, that life is a big canvas where we each have a brush and paint to choose the colors to paint the tapestry of our lives. He truly had all the time his hands to take a paint and a brush, and he chose the colors to paint the tapestry of his life. And we want to thank God for the life, the days that God gave him. And I was saying during the week, he achieved in his 25 years what a lot of people fail to achieve in 100 years. He achieved a lot. He left a taste in all of us. And we celebrate a good life here that was well lived. His departure, or his funeral, so to say, maybe I can correct myself, his home going ceremony is fresh air to celebrate such a good life in the midst of so much that is happening in our country. You know, people are dying, and all over us, South Africa has done good stories to tell lately. But to be here to celebrate such a life, to say there are still good people out here. Hallelujah. There are still good people whose lives can be celebrated. And it's such a fresh, the fresh air we are breathing now. And we want to say, beloved, it is well. Still, it is well. It is well, it's well with him, and it shall be well with him. Kindly let me get to the word of God, and we are almost supposed to be out. I'm going to ask that I draw your attention to the word of God in the book of John, chapter 3. There we are going to read the Lord Jesus speaking here. In my Bible, it's the letters are in red, as in most Bibles, showing that it was the words of Christ. And I'm reading there from verse 14, and it says, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. And verse 18 says, he who believes in him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Let us pray. Ifela udutsi jwa jwalo isale unta umphodisi se matswalo Father, we thank you for the word of God, and we are asking, Father, right now that you bless your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, where we are reading, beloveds, before we go, the Bible here talks about something that is very important, and that is eternal life. Bophelo bo sa feleng. When Jesus came into this world, he did not bring the church. He did not bring the pastor. He did not bring the garments that we wear. He did not bring religion. But he brought eternal life. When God brought Jesus into this world here, he came to solve man's biggest problem. And that problem is separation. Jesus came to bridge the gap that existed that no one could close. And the Bible says, where we read here, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Because when Jesus died on the cross, he did not die for himself. In fact, that is one man who chose the hour when he should die. Who knew how he was going to die? Who chose when to give somebody a permission to get in? Jesus did not die because he was arrested. He died because he gave himself. And why did he die? He came to solve man's problem. Man today has three problems. One is the problem of sin. Sin, since it came into the human race, sin is not sin. Sin separates man from God. Sin separated. You see, the problem that we see today in this world, it's a cause. It is sin came into the world. It raised the problem in the garden of Eden, when there was still innocence and beauty. The Bible says man's first murder was committed by the siblings. A man murdered his brother. Why? It is the problem of sin. When Jesus died, he came to solve the problem of sin, because sin separates a man from God. Sin disqualifies a person from getting into heaven. With sin, a man cannot inherit heaven. That is why Jesus paid with his own blood. His blood made peace between man and God. And the second problem is death. Hallelujah. The second problem of man, it is a spiritual death. Man is walking today, but in the eyes of God, until somebody comes to Jesus, that person, he's not alive. The Bible says, he is dead in his own sins. What a person needs today, he needs life. And God in Jesus brought life. Life, the Bible says, as Moses hanged the snake on the tree, we all remember the story. The Bible says, everyone who looked there, unapila. Jesus, when he hanged on the tree, there is a song that we used to sing that used to say, look and live. My brother, look and live. So that on the cross is a symbol that all can see. God says, just look up and believe.
Hallelujah. You know, some people simply don't want. I don't mind when somebody does not believe God. Because democracy started with God. God never forces somebody to believe in Jesus. He never does. As Christians, we don't have a right to force people to believe the gospel because God does not force anybody. He says, you have got the right to choose. That is why the Bible says, behold, I have put life and death before you. Choose. You have a right to choose. The second problem is spiritual death. Man is dead in his own sins. And when Jesus came here, he brought life that qualifies a person that even if you can see death, the Bible says chapter 2 verse 9, it says he tasted death for all. Hallelujah. He tasted death. The death of Jesus on the cross was a separate. It was a painful death. Not physical death. Let me say, my sister, you said, the third problem of man is the physical death. And the last one in that order, it is the physical death. The two he has taken care of, sin and spiritual death. That is why there in the graveyard, I'm going to read the scripture that says, for the last enemy to be destroyed is death. Dying in Christ is a good way to die. Dying outside of Christ is a bad way to die. That is why the Bible says it is appointed unto men to die once, and after that, judgment. The prophet Amos said, therefore, since I will do this thing to you, prepare to meet your God. The assignment that we have today is to prepare to meet your God. Because one day you are going to meet God. And this is going to happen. The challenge is, when you die, when will you spend your eternity? Dying in Jesus is a good way to die. Dying outside of Jesus is a bad way to die. I always tell people that if you can choose anything, choose not to die without Jesus. Don't die without Jesus. Because Jesus is the only man who died when he was not dead. He died when he had life, but yet he faced the life of a sinner. He felt in himself what it is to die without God. He felt it in the Garden of Gethsemane. He is the only person that faced this monster that is death. And he faced it. I call. And he confronted death. Death and Jesus met, and they had looked at each other. When I was growing up, he used to say, if you have a dog that is vicious at home, those guys share a room. Don't look at the dog that is vicious on the ice. Because when you do, provoke the dog. It thinks you are fighting. Don't look at it. They say even the lion. Don't look at it in the eyes. Because
it thinks you are already fighting. And let me tell you today, it comes to death. Jesus faced death eyeball to eyeball. And he went into the grave. And after he rose, he said, I was dead. And now I am alive. I have the peace of Hades and the place of death. And behold, I am alive. A person who dies in Christ is the only person who has the reason not to fear. That is why he says, do not fear, because I have conquered death. And I want to believe that where he is now, he doesn't fear death. No, he did not. If you are saved today, if you have Jesus today, no matter where death can meet you, you are not afraid to die. You are not afraid to go. As I hear, I'm not afraid to go. Amen. I'm not afraid to go. I'm ready. Where I'm going, I know. But this is just only 15. Amen. I'm not looking for a DJ in darkness, ma'am. Unali pulelo etwing. How not see bang? No, I can't follow a man all my life and say I don't know where I'm going. I don't go where he's taking me. I have no business to entrust my soul to somebody who is going to tell me that I don't know where I'm taking you. But Jesus says, I'm going to the Father. And after that, I'm going to come. And where I am, you will be there also. Hallelujah. There is nobody who said that. Who said, I'm going to get you. And when I get you, I'm taking you where I am. That is where he is now. Hallelujah. He is sleeping in him. And I'm saying here, as we are about to go, whatever you do, don't die without Jesus. Because the Bible says, he who believes has eternal life. But he who does not believe is condemned already. He's not going to be condemned. And what does the Bible say he's condemned for? He says he does not believe in God's only Son. In other words, when you meet God one day, God is not going to ask you or now who was your pastor, who was your bishop. What he's going to ask you, the question is, what have you done with my son? What have you done? I see him on the cross. He bore your sin there. He bore your judgment there. You should have been blessed, but the judgment on God, he paid his body. He himself bore our own sins on his body on the key so that we may live for God. Hallelujah. The Bible says, whoever believes, that we may not be now. There is an offer of life. There is an offer of life. There is an offer of life while you are still alive. Drink the living water, eternal life that Jesus gives. He is the only one that can give water of eternal life. The Bible says, the word of God, for salvation is not found in any man. There is no salvation that under the sun, he alone can save. He is the only one that can take a man to heaven or a woman to heaven. While you are here, it is your time to drink living water of eternal life. There is one man in the Bible, as I'm closing, says, the Bible says he left this world without God. He lived his own life. And he didn't care about man or God. He never cared. He didn't care about God. He didn't care about any man. So the Bible says. And the Bible says when he died and he woke up, the Bible says in great torment, he cried out. He didn't want a bucket of water. He said, just a drop. A drop will make it. Because what you get from Jesus is for eternity. It solves your eternal destiny. When you come to Jesus, you see, the greatest gift that you can give to yourself is meeting Jesus, accepting Jesus as your Savior. This man prays, he cries out to God. And he says, God, send somebody in my family so that he may warn my brothers that they should not come to this place because I am in torment. Beloveds, let me tell you today, I'm a preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ. There is heaven to enjoy for every soul that turns to God and be saved. But there is also hell to shun. It's real. Heaven is real and hell is not joke. It's dead serious. Otherwise, he could not die. The Bible says, he who looks up to him, he has eternal life. And this man prays at the wrong place, at the wrong time. He says, all I ask for is just a drop. I don't ask much. I'm just asking for a drop. And what does God say? God says, but you had your time. You had an opportunity. It will be very sad to bury this person here who have exemplified what it is to die a good man, and you die as you are. Let us close our eyes. He has fallen asleep in Jesus. He will rise again. In him. And I'm asking, as a point of reflection, as we go, should death get you, where do you hope to spend eternity? Eternity is real. There's no question about it. It's real. There are no two ways about it. There are only two places. There is heaven. And there is hell. I wish I couldn't even mention that word. But when Jesus came on his cross, he came to solve the problem that man has. Don't reject the Son of God. And Father, I pray Father, that Ari has fallen asleep. And I pray, Father, that many may experience the forgiveness of sin, salvation that you alone can give. Before I call them to come forward, he has fallen asleep. He has met his creator. His life says it. The fruits of his life say it. Today, now, can be a day to receive Jesus in your heart. Bible says whoever believes in him, whoever believes in him has eternal life. And I'm asking anybody here, he who says, or she who says, I want to spend my eternity in heaven, and I want to accept Jesus as Savior, wherever you are. And I'm asking that you slip up your hand to say, I want to be saved. There is our daughter there. God loves you. He says, he doesn't judge you. He says, come as you are. You'll be saved. There is no sin that God cannot forgive. There is no depth where the love of God cannot reach. God bless you. Is there anybody here? There you are. I see you. Anybody else? I'm praying now. My time is up. And I'm saying, as the preacher of the gospel, I'm hoping I won't have to appear before God and say, what have you told the people? And I will say, God, I told them that if they don't accept your son, they will perish, as your word says. I see you, my sister, there. I see you. I see you there. I see you. Anybody else? And let me tell you today, please, I'm not going to ask you to come forward. Please. Can you just stand on your feet? Jesus said, whoever is ashamed of me, I'll be ashamed of him or her. If you say you accept Jesus, stand up on your feet. You were there. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed to have people accept Christ. I'm not ashamed of him. And I'm praying for you. Father, I pray for them. Lord, I pray that your love reach them where they are. Meet them, Father, at the point where they are in. And I pray that, Holy Spirit, you give them a confirmation that they are children of God. And I'm asking that you bless them. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. If you did believe what I'm preaching or what the word of God is saying, I'm here to tell you that this is how I ended up here. There was no magic. I believed in him first, and then I became who I am. God bless you. We are about to go. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor Mohlomi Motete. Thank you. Thank you very much for a very touchy sermon. We are now proceeding to Sterkfontein. Is it Sterkfontein? Sterkfontein graveyard. And we'll come back here after the service at the gravesite. And we humbly request, please, that we all drive behind the hearse. I mean, I've seen funerals where people are just rushing forward and rushing back. Respectfully, we ask that we just drive behind the hearse. We'll get there in time. I know that we are late. We humbly apologize. But I thank you, my brothers, for not wearing yellow jackets. You chose the right colors for today. And those of you who know the truth, right? You know what yellow stands for, girl. Black and white is better these days. So we're moving straight to the cemetery in Sterkfontein, and we shall be led. Some of you are only catching it now. It's okay. It's all right. We move right along. And the messages, we do believe that your messages were to strengthen the families. They were not for show. So we will give them to the families as we proceed to the gravesite. And we are going to once again also humbly request that we open space. Moruti will lead us, and then the family follows. And we ask gentle brothers who have been asked by the family to come and help us carry Ari to his last resting place.
Tinkela, kamisha so with the lopa oh utalonzwa na hura birita ho tinkela ridire elle kamisha.
Raleboha, thank you. Banabesu, retoko pa se tswe tswe, reska leba la lebakala rona laobamo. I know that we do have a DJ, but reska leba la hore haritela mobu. But wana batela mobu, banida tuso. Tuso ya hore nalwena, retobina. Reska tuwe la DJ fela. Rebine because retlot idisa. Retlot itika bupilo that was well lived. Liska libala rona reza situsa rona juang. and hona jwanong re na le challenge tshwantse re bontshe batho bana ba tswang ka ntlele ko Nthabi a nyetsweng teng re ba bontsho retsa jwang dintho le ska mphoqa he ya kere thank you se ke na ke nehela back to ntate Moruti Matete.
There was a request here, hore, babamba fihle, maybe a minute or so. Then we let the DJ play a song, and then. Oh, little bean. Thank you so much. Can we please take a song, therefore, and then. Re kopa hore ba thusang ho tlatlang ka mona please bontate re or any those who are nominated for pall bearing work sense bankile.
Oh, see, stani, oh, ah.
One of those important moments for the family where they have to find this time to get a closure to say final farewell to this life that was so very well lived. We are going to ask that this Saba Arbulele Katape.
Baba siyabonga mawethu namandla onke sithwele Nkosi yami waze kwabala somandla phinduke nathi ke Nkosi mawethu sisazobeka lo mzimba mawethu namandla onke sibonakalise uzambule awethu uthandeka uThixo wena ongayenzi into oqala into ungayiqhebezeli bawethu namandla onke siyabulela ngegama lika Yesu wase Nazareth. Amen.
Thank you, Bob. Then we are just going to read scripture here. Ha re sa rutla re sa dithotse ngata se re sa mosebetsi ona fela, and then that shall be it. We are reading, and after that, after reading, we are going to ask our brothers to lower the casket, and again, what needs to be done, the doves, they know what to do, and that will be taken care of then. But someone would say, how are the dead raised up? With what body do they come? Foolish one. What you sow is not made alive unless it dies. Thank you so much. And what you sow, you do not sow that body that shall be, but mere grain. Perhaps wheat or some other grain. But God gives it a body as he pleases, and to each seed its own body. All flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another of fish, and another of animals, another of birds. There are also celestial bodies and terrestrial bodies. But the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another. There is one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, and another glory of the stars. And for one star differs from one another in glory. So also is the resurrection of the dead. The body is sown in corruption, it is raised in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There is a natural body, there is a spiritual body. And so it is written, the first man Adam became a living being, and last Adam became a life-giving spirit. However, the spiritual is not first, but the natural, and afterward the spiritual. The first man was of the earth, made of the dust, the second man is the Lord from heaven. And as was of the man of dust, so also are those who are made of dust. And as is the heavenly man, so also are those who are heavenly. And as we have borne the image of the man of dust, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly man. Now this I say, brethren, that all flesh, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does corruption inherit corruption. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. Then when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. That is the word of God, and by this word we are going to allow them to lower the body, and then we shall come after that. May you please take over.
He's going home. He's going home. He's going home. He's going home.
Oh, Okay. Thank you, thank you. We implore you once again to just sing your lungs out. Any occasion where you find Arethabeng, our true DJ. DJ. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for Sebedisa Namo. So Ali was a drummerful person. So we get here to discover that the casket is way bigger than the hole that was dug. And it can only happen when it's Ali. He just loves drama. And wherever he is right now, he's laughing his lungs out. Look at them. Look at them. What will they be without me? But it's one of those signs that we definitely are going to miss him dearly. And I suppose he's also insisting that we read some of the messages that you all wrote for the family, as we continue to comfort the family, that they know in this time of sorrow and grief, they are not alone. This message comes from Bolina Tejo. Bolina says, tears of grief and heartfelt sorrows are the companion of those beautiful flowers. May Alice's world be full of such beauty. Thank you for the message. This message is from Dineo Lungu. Dineo, I hope it's not Lungu, because this person writes like me. You are remembered and you are in our hearts. Rest easy, Ali. So in all this. I don't know later I'm wet. Okay, I'll get the most. Okay. Alright. This one is from Brenda Lungu. Says days will pass, but your memories will only become stronger. We'll always keep you in our prayers. Sleep peacefully. You live on forever in our hearts, where you belong. Ntabi and Tony, Ali was the heartbeat of the family. He will be clearly missed. May you keep all the good memories and continue to spread the love that he shared. Keep strong in the Lord. Love, bless, Kani and Tandi. And that's where the messages end. And we do have a message as well. We'll try and see if we can play that recorded message from a friend who is in the US. In the meantime, DJ, you can go back to your thing.
Such an amazing human being, inside and out. Those who knew you are very fortunate to have known you. You are larger than life, and you always lived your life to the fullest. Now that you're gone, may all the beautiful memories be a blessing. You were definitely one of a kind, and you will be missed dearly. Woman and Tabby, Uncle Tony, I pray the Lord Almighty gives you strength during this difficult time. Fly high, Ari, forever in my heart. I love you always. Pile.
this music. This was Ari. You're allowed to dance where you are. Ari loved my piano. DJ, give him a mouth, please.
Thank you very much. All right, so very simple. I'm going to teach everybody, okay? Just goes like this. Shames. Everyone, come and join us. Come on. Okay. Very simple. How about you keep a hip and elbow? Again, clap.
Two key points in his life, with a womb and with a grave. What a phenomenal person he was. He overcame the womb and also the grave here. He's dictating terms even in death. He was a phenomenal. Brother Boy, we are really having a blessed time here. It's wonderful to be laying death, to sleep such a wonderful person. It's a privilege for all of us here. Let's have one more song, and then it's like it's working out here. Let's give it up again, the song. Whether you're here or DJ. Okay. You have to hear.
Yeah.
totally awesome. We are continuing, beloved, to be blessed the Lord so much. And if there are pastors who are here, we can kindly request them to move quickly forward and that we do all this together. Amen. Beloved, as we bid farewell to our son, nephew, brother, cousin, so we are going to ask that whoever is appointed to come to the end of the year may come and read what is written, the message that is written on the tombstone. I'm just reading the word here. And as Josiah turned and saw the tombs that were there on the mountain, and he sent them to the bones out of the tombs and burned them on the altar, and defiled it according to the word of the Lord, which was spoken by the man of God, who proclaimed these words. Then he said, "That gravestone, what gravestone is that?" Against the altar, or better. And he said, "Let him alone, let no one move his bones." So they let his bones alone with the bones of the prophet who came from Samaria. And beloved, what I like from this scripture that I just read, this man called Josiah, he asked the people when he saw the tombstone. And the question that he asked was, among these tombs that are here, what gravestone is that one? And the men of the city, the Bible says, they responded and said, "This is the grave of the man of God." Now, it was not the family who said, but the men of the city. Man left an impact so much that the men of the city could remain after he was gone, and they were still talking about him. May we look at our ways as individuals during the time that God has brought us, the days to live. What shall be said about us when we are gone? Men of the city, they said, the man of God. And we are saying also, beloved, this is the tombstone of the man of God. The man who represented God. The man in whose life God was seen. The man who carried God. The man who made us see the beauty of God. The man who made us to see that life can be lived, yet it can still please God. And they say this is the tomb of the man of God. And then we are saying also, this is the tomb of the son, of the nephew. But this is again the tombstone of the man of God. May the Lord bless you as you unveil on behalf of the family. Maybe you can come this side, where you can get a better view, so that you cast your eyes there. But for the family that is unveiling, oh, you're here.
In loving memory of Arethabeng and Lennon, born 1997, 20th of March, died 20th. Died on 7th of August 2022. Buried on 14th of August 2022.
May God richly bless you. This is the message, but there is another message there. You have not read that one. Yeah, that one there. Over there. Yes, please.
A man about town, Ari, you touched us all with your smile, with your charm, your love, your humility, your respect. We will miss you always and carry you always in our hearts forever.
Thank you so much. And as they say, we also say, may he rest in power. Amen. Then we are going to ask, beloved, that we have all of us at the Kenya Moku, and then after that we shall close. Or maybe before we give it that everybody, we don't know if the family has an intention to come and do it here also. Think you should come. Please come. Can we give them a good song as they come? As they make their way here.
Yes. Oh! Young guy.